NPR has in recent weeks granted section of Reno 1
exclusion.
Assisting a medical tour from China, including a medical mask, a family of gloves, and antiseptic wipes.
But as it battles to try to keep the U.S. economy from collapsing amid quarantine orders and halted commerce,
the Trump administration so far has
insisted that too broad a removal of tariffs
imposed over the past 20 months, and some 370 billion Chinese imports annually.
The European Union executive has moved to formalize an agreement reached by EU finance ministers on March 5th to suspend the EU budget rules and put limits on borrowing so that governments have a free hand in fighting the coronavirus. The European Commission, the guardian of EU rules, proposed to activate the general affairs clause in the rules to respond to the pandemic that caused lockdown in non-EU countries and the closure of U.S. borders. EU rules says governments have to keep cutting their budget deficits until they reach a balance or surplus and have to reduce public debt every year to bring it below 60% of GDP. Once the Commission proposal is formally accepted by EU finance ministers at their next meeting, government spending despite coronavirus will be excluded from Commission's calculation of deficit and debt.
Foreign companies eager for government aid to curb fallout from the coronavirus crisis, Texas, is cutting out to investors.
For more on the story, we go to our next segment.
Boeing's decision echoes a similar measure taken by the largest U.S. airlines in an effort to win over taxpayer support for the request for stimulus packages. As the fast coronavirus virtually reduces air travel demand and hits the global economy.
Boeing has said it wants at least $60 billion in government loan guarantees to stop a drop up in the U.S. aero manufacturing supply chain, already reeling from the year old grounding of a big fast selling 737 MAX jetliner after fatal crashes. Democrats and some Republicans have been insisting on limits and executive compensation, buybacks, and dividends as part of any government assistance.
U.S. Trump said he would demand limits on any companies receiving assistance.
Panasonic Corp said it will temporarily suspend production batteries for the venture with U.S. electric car maker Tesla Inc. in Nevada because of the coronavirus outbreak. Panasonic said in an email to statement that the electronics company, which supplies battery cells for Tesla's electric vehicle, will scale down production at a so-called Gigafactory 1 earlier this week before closing it for 14 days. Spokeswoman trying to determine how the suspension would affect Tesla, which produces battery packs using Panasonic cells at the Nevada plant. Tesla on Thursday said,
"The next Radio Thailand News Hour to give you suggestions on things to see, hear, and experience. This has been Wadi Sang with an Apple One."
From the Public Relations Department of the Royal Swedish Government, that would need our.
Thank you. المال المدفون تحت الأرض.
Radio România Internațional. Aquí Bucarest, Radio România Internațional. Pueden sintonizar por onda corta vía satélite y también en internet en la página www.rri.ro, que es nuestra página web que da todas las frecuencias de transmisión por onda corta.
Asimismo, pueden mantener el contacto con nosotros siguiéndonos en nuestra página de Facebook Radio Rumanía Internacional.
Les deseamos buen auspicio.
Muy buenas noches, estimados oyentes. Seguidamente les presentamos nuestro programa informativo de hoy.
The in the front word have listed a number of
in football where all Champions League and European matches have been suspended by UEFA and have noted all national team games in have also been postponed, including all of matches for the Euro 2020 Championship, which have already been moved to next year.
The Premier League clubs are coming increasingly under fire as they furlough non-playing staff, putting them on temporary leave while continuing to choose huge wages for players. Across Europe, teams like Barcelona have taken a 70% pay cut to allow other staff to retain their jobs. It's led British politicians to have Premier League clubs living in a moral vacuum. But earlier Bournemouth announced their boss, Eddie Howe, is one of a number of staff at the club to take a significant voluntary pay cut.
Thanks very much to Katie. Well, every day the BBC World Service is producing a coronavirus podcast.
It's today's edition.
Global update on Wednesday, the 1st of April.
Hello, I'm Oliver Conway with a message on the pandemic.
In Italy, officials say the daily number of fatalities lowest level for 6 days.
The more than 60 doctors have now died.
The authorities in the Netherlands are investigating whether a group or herd immunity could stop the spread of the
vaccine. The have been cancelled.
More than 30,000 people have now died of coronavirus in Europe.
More than three quarters of them in Italy and Spain.
Israel has recorded its lowest number of deaths for nearly a week, while cases rose slightly.
The outbreak
continues to take a heavy toll on the medical profession, more than 60 doctors have died.
Giovanni Leone
is from the Italian National Federation of Doctors.
They weren't about the way the treatment they proper bombs, and they weren't given them. In other words, the treatment is completely...
Thanks for listening.
To Word of Earth,
Global Update.
Millions of people working from home during this coronavirus pandemic are all using video conferencing apps as house parties, hangouts, FaceTime, Zoom, just name a few. But just how worried should we be about privacy when my colleague James Gill from our technology team has written a piece about Zoom bombing? You probably saw it today, James. Good to have you back with us. For those that haven't met us yet.
Говорит Международное радио Китая.
В эфире Международное радио Китая. И, как всегда, в начале информационный выпуск. И вот его главная тема. Делать крупные города Китая более интеллектуальными. Во вторник в континентальном Китае зеленые протесты снова слышат края вокруг.
While a group of European doctors highlights the plight of refugees in camps across the Greek islands and urged officials to evacuate these areas to prevent a tragedy from taking place. The number of cases in Slovenia rose to 841 and death toll to 15. Slovenia has reported 13 deaths so far and the number of positive cases grew to 457, while three doctors working at Tsarnaev University clinics reported to be infected with COVID-19. Fatalities in Bulgaria rose to 9 and the number of cases to 412. The Montenegrin government extended lockdown measures until the 10th of April and the country lost 2 of its citizens to the virus. In the U.S., the coronavirus killed 884 people over the past 24 hours, a new one-day record for the country that put the death toll in America to 5,102. The number of reported cases killed by 5,200 over the past 24 hours, 215,020 by Johns Hopkins University's coronavirus tracker. New York authorities rushed to bring in an army of medical volunteers Wednesday as the statewide death toll from the coronavirus doubled in 72 hours. As hot spots flared around the U.S. in places like New Orleans and Southern California, the nation's biggest city, New York, was the hardest hit of them all, with bodies loaded onto refrigerated morgue trucks by gurney and septic outside overwhelmed hospitals. In other news, the U.N. New York contracted its climate change summit the city of Glasgow in November has been confined due to the coronavirus pandemic, the British government said on Monday. The coronavirus has killed 47,249 people and the number of infections has passed 936,000 globally. In Iraq, 52 people have died from the virus so far and the number of cases was 728. Saudi Arabia deaths, positive COVID-19 deaths were recorded, bringing the death toll to 16. A Palestinian who was released by Israel after 1 year imprisonment has tested positive for the virus. Death toll from COVID-19 was 37 in Morocco, 62 in Egypt, and 12 in Tunisia. Among the victims is a South African scientist named Professor Dr. Yuka Ramji, who was famous for her work against HIV infection. And it was in the Chinese news brought to you by the Water Church Radio in Ankara. Thanks for listening. Goodbye. The Grand Mosque and Dar al-Shifa, or hospital, in Sivas province is among the most important architectural monuments in Anatolia.
Damit neigte sich Ihr bisheriges Panorama für heute leider schon wieder dem Ende entgegen. Liebe Freunde, schön, dass Sie dabei waren. Ich würde mich freuen, wenn Sie auch morgen wieder einschalten. Ich danke Ihnen für alles Gute. Machen Sie es gut. Tschüss.